Hi there. Welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie, and it's great to have you here. Today, I want to show you how you can make your PowerPoints more impactful by adding background music in PowerPoint to all your slides. Now, once I show you how to insert the music, I want to go through all the different options you have to customize the settings to make sure you get it to the closest what you want it to. So let's get started on how to add background music in PowerPoint to all your slides. I have this PowerPoint that I created, and you can see it's loaded up with dog photos of different types and inspirational quotes as I go through this. Now, already with the images and the quotes, it gives a certain feeling, but really to up it, adding music can go that extra step. So if I was presenting this without the music, and if I just go here and hit play from beginning, you can see that, yes, it would catch your attention, but I want to be able to go to that next level and add some music in it that's inspirational, maybe fun, to get that across in my message about dogs. Now, what I want here is to add music. So this is going to be this first step here. We can do this in a couple of different ways. If I go up to insert here under the menu, and then I want you to go across the ribbon to the other end here where it says audio. Now, if we click on this, we can just go from audio on my PC. And I did download, so the audio and the pictures are from Pixabay. So this is all, I don't have to worry about copyright on this. And I downloaded the music as well from there. So I can go ahead and insert it. And then you'll notice I get this right here, this sound that I entered in, and I can test it out by hitting play. Jump ahead. So to make sure it was the right one. Now, I'm just gonna delete this real quickly to show you. You can actually drag this in. So if I move over and I just have my folder opened here with my PowerPoint where I saved it, and here's the music again. You can drag music over and just drop it in, and that inserts it as well. So now that we have our music inserted into our slideshow, let's go ahead and add some customization to it. So we've inserted our music and we previewed it by hitting the play. Let's go ahead and just play our slideshow here. So I'm going to just hit play from the beginning, and you'll notice that nothing happens. It doesn't automatically start or anything. If I go ahead and hit play here, the music starts. So if I go ahead to the next slide though, what you're going to notice is it stops. So if we want to have it go to the next slide without stopping, we have to make some adjustments to it. So I'm going to get out of the present mode, and where I want to go to, and I'm just going to click on the first slide. I want you to pay attention to when I click out on the sound icon here. And if I look up into the menu, I get two more menu items. I get audio format and playback. So playback is where we're going to be adjusting things. Now, real quickly, I just want to talk about audio format. So the audio format is just about how this looks here. So if you notice, if I click on one of these, you can see how it changes, and you can go through and you can make some changes to this if you wanted to look different. For me, I actually hide this a lot of times when I'm presenting, and I'll show you how to do that with the playback menu. So I'm just going to undo those ones that I just did. So if you want to change the look, go to audio format. But now if we want to adjust our settings, go to playback right here. Now, first of all, take a look at some of the options that we can do here. So a very quick way to get everything playing while you click through your slideshow is to just click on this, play in the background. And what's going to happen when we choose play in the background, it's going to go through and pick a certain customization that will make this happen. So if I click on this, you'll see that we got some clicks here that just got clicked, and then we have start automatically. So now if I go back and let's just go ahead to slideshow and we'll play from beginning again. Notice we have our music playing. As I go through the different slides now, you're gonna see that the music goes through, and I'm just gonna go through and click through a few different ones, and you can see it doesn't stop, just like that. So I'm going to get out of this and the music stops. So that's a quick way just to get things up and running if you just need your music in the background. But let's go back to the first slide here and dive a little bit more back into here, into the playback to see what other things you can do. So I'm going to go ahead and get started with audio options right here. Since when I choose play in background, this is where we made our few first changes. Now I can quickly get rid of this play in background options by going no style here. And you can see how it went back to the default when I put the sound in, which was just in click sequence. Now I want to start over here at volume. So if I drop down here, you can see we can go from low, medium, high, and we also have mute. And we, under the start, how do we want to start the music to start with it? Is it in click sequence? Is it automatically, or is it when clicked on? You can see when I just chose this one, it went to automatically. We also have this option here, play across slides. I needed that to be checked because I wanted the music to keep going as I went to different slides. This next option, loop until stopped. Now, let's say if it was a shorter song and if I was spending more time on different slides, it would just loop again. So I wouldn't ever have the music stop. It would just go over and over again if you thought you might run out of music on what you picked. Now, the hide during show is what this looks like right here. If you don't want it to be shown, just go ahead and click it. It doesn't remove it when we're in this format here, when we're editing, but as soon as we go to our slideshow and hit play, notice that we don't see it anywhere. So if I quickly get out of that there, notice it also didn't play because when I'm in playback, I didn't have it to have it start automatically like I did before. Now you might be wondering, what is this rewind after playing? Well, let's say if we had our music going through and then you were presenting again and you wanted the music to start at the same point, it would kind of do a rewind to that. So you wouldn't have the loop until stopped if you had this one selected, because this is going to loop anyway, but this would go back to the very beginning on it. So these are some audio options here that probably what you'll play with most, but some other things that you can do to kind of advance it more. If we go over to the left, and I'm just going to walk through some of these, this is just a preview. This is the same as hitting play here, but with bookmarks, what we get to do. So if I jump ahead here, and let's say I add a bookmark, and then I'm going to go ahead and just add another bookmark. Now, if I hover over this, you can see we get shortcuts where I can go Alt plus Home and Alt plus End to skip. So we can, if the song was longer or you wanted to get to a different part of the song as you're presenting, you could go through and then you could jump ahead to the bookmarks also. So you could use the shortcuts or just click and you would know where to jump ahead to, just to kind of maybe change that mood of the slideshow at that point. You can also remove these. If you have them selected, you can remove them from here. Another handy feature is the trim audio function. When I select this, allows you to trim from the beginning or the end. So if you knew there was parts, maybe it was too slow at the beginning, you want to jump into a little bit more action, you could trim it, and you can also trim it from the end. So you just pull those in and then go ahead and hit okay, and then we'd have it trimmed. Now the thing is, it might start off maybe being that abrupt beginning and no, since we kind of got rid of the fade in and also in the fade out at the end, we could change this here. So we have our fade duration. You can go ahead and actually add a fade in and a fade out. So you can adjust the timing depending what you want. So there's no abrupt cutoff when you do it. So you can go through all these different options to adjust your audio inside your PowerPoint when you're going through presenting it to make sure that your PowerPoint is a lot more impactful. I hope this video showed you how to insert background music into your PowerPoint. If not, I hope you liked all the dog pictures and all those inspirational dog quotes here too. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.